Hey everyone, do you want to know how to get more repeat customers and larger average order value using this strategy? Let's find out how. So guys, just before we get into how to get more customers using post-purchase upsells quickly and easily, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel, growing rapidly, okay guys? It's a lot of fun, and every video I'm going to give away a winning product that you can use today to start kicking goals, okay guys? Let's get straight into this. All right, so a number of you probably don't know what post-purchase upsells are to get repeat customers or larger average order value in that as well. Is a post-purchase upsell is for people who have purchased, so they've actually gone ahead and they've purchased and they see it after they've actually purchased, okay? So we're trying to get them to buy again, another item, so that they add more items to their cart and they increase the average order value, right? And this is important because it's 100% extra profit, okay? Especially as you're scaling, okay? So we do this for a number of reasons. Obviously, one, we just want to make more money, right? You know, that's our goal. At the end of the day, we just want to make money in our back pocket, and that's how we do that. That's one of the ways we do it. Increases the lifetime value of our customers, okay? So it actually helps build more trust with them, because especially if you're sending more products to them and they have a good experience across all products, they're going to come back and buy again. Your average order value. So, you know, your average order value might go from $30 overall to, let's say, $35. Now, people might think, oh, yeah, it's not much. If you think of that as percentage, let's say that's a sixth. Let's make it a fifth, about a 20%. Okay, guys, let's say that as an example. And that can make all the difference. That $5 times by 50 orders a day is $250 in your back pocket. Okay, guys, so that's really important to really keep in mind. Does that make sense? Allows us to scale higher. So this is actually the most important part, in my opinion. As competition actually becomes more fierce and a lot more people are doing drop shipping, people are trying to find other sources of passive forms of income, having that competitive edge is really important. And a lot of this comes back to the back end. Everyone's so focused purely on the front end, they forget it's actually the back end that really ends up making them the most money. And it's things like this that actually make the most money. It's not about, it is about having an ad that gets engagement in terms of clicks and obviously is getting sales, but it's important that you don't forget the back end, because if you do forget the back end, I assure you, most of your money will be lost there. And that's why most people if they are profitable, they're barely profitable. Trust me when I say it. Okay, and again, it just allows us to spend more money to acquire a customer so we can out-compete the competition. So if we have 50 competitors and they're all got the same type of price for the product, but you know we're getting some of those customers and they can only spend $20, but if we can spend $25, that makes a huge difference, because all of a sudden we can just completely out-compete them. So that is one of the keys, okay guys? So what are the best post-purchase upsell apps? So I pretty much have three, there's three that I have found that are my favorites, and I've used all three of them, is OneClickUp, Upsell, Reconvert, and Carthook. So let me just explain the pros and cons here and now. So OneClickUp, Upsell is $49 a month, okay? It does charge 1.5% transaction fee for every PPU, post-purchase upsell. If you know they add an extra three items to that you've upsold them, every one of those will get a 1.5%. Again, that you know does cut into a little bit, but for what it's worth, it's worth it. And on average, if it's set up properly and you have a good product and audience match, it can get you about 10 to 15%, max 15%. I actually, if I'm honest, probably see most people at around the probably 7 to 12% mark. That's where most people seem to sit and lie. But that's still extra money, so who cares? Allows you to split test. So one of the things that OneClickUpsell has recently brought in is the ability to actually split test every funnel step. So you can have six funnel steps, but you can have a split test of each of those funnel steps and see which converts at a higher rate. Obviously, the more higher rate, the more money you get. Simple as that, right? It integrates straight into Shopify, so it is a third-party app. So you do have to go to their website and install it, because it's a private app, but it connects with Stripe and PayPal. You do need reference transactions for PayPal. You need to call them about that. OneClickUpsell actually have guidance on that as well. It's a pain, and it takes like a week or something, but you have to do it. It's ridiculous. Anyway, when you get to that point, you'll know what I mean. So it's good for those wanting to use post-purchase upsells that are still learning to scale, okay? So if you're on a bit of a budget, but you are scaling, then this is perfect, okay, guys? You can customize the thank you page. It integrates with ESPs like Klaviyo, the big one, Google Analytics, and Facebook, and it even converts with integrates with Trackify as well. Okay, so that's really, really important to know, because I use Trackify. I know a heap of people use Trackify. If it doesn't integrate with Trackify, it means that you'd have to put the pixel back on the store, but we don't want that. Trackify is so much better. So it does have some problems. One, it is a third-party checkout, which means that it does have integration problems. So a number of apps for discounts, let's say like Wheelio, I believe Wheelio is getting integration with it, but it won't auto-inject the discount code, unfortunately. Things like that, okay, guys? They do have a number of apps that they do integrate with, like let's say with Quantity Breaks and a number of others, I keep forgetting them, that you can use that are really good, don't get me wrong, but that's something to be mindful of. It's definitely the worst part with Shopify is the checkout and post-purchase phase. It's a nightmare. Now, the other one is reconvert. Now, I actually recommend reconvert, change your thank you page, okay? It's free for 50 orders a month. Allows you to now have product recommendations. You can have a pop-up and you can have a discount on the page. You can have share. It's got a heap of different functions. I mainly just use the pop-up, the pop-up and the product recommendation. And I try and get their mobile number for their birthday, because you can do that with SMS bump. Which is really good, because especially if you're building a brand store, imagine if, you know, 6 months down the line, someone's birthday, they get a text message for a whopping 30% discount, they come back and buy, and that's all autopilot, okay? So that's really cool, I like that. Increases average order value by again, 5-10%. You're probably looking at it realistically 7-12. They all do about that, I would say, on a realistic figure. Again, it integrates with SMS bump. Easy to set up and install. Literally, it's just an app. I'm gonna show you that in a second. You can customize the video. So you can add a custom video, or you can add an image on your thank you page, which is pretty good because you can try and upsell them, as well as you can do, you know, say what your shipping times are, okay? You can tell them what to expect, okay? Because everyone, the thing with thank you pages is they've got 100% conversion rate. Everyone that purchases goes to a thank you page, 100%. Okay, so you can use that as your foundation to try and inform them. So even if you are doing many post-purchase upsells through Reconvert, you can actually put on there just like a message saying our average shipping time is blah. Okay, it helps reduce your customer service and chargebacks. Has messenger integration and all third-party apps integration, because it's just purely a thank you page. You don't have any integration problems, because it's still the standard Shopify checkout. So you don't have any integration problems. That is a massive bonus, especially as you're starting out. It's just one less thing to worry about. Cart hook as well is also a third-party checkout, okay? It's completely third-party. One-click upsell, you'd manage it all in Shopify. This is actually a third-party interface entirely. So that's the downside. It integrates with Facebook, Google. At this stage, it does integrate with Klaviyo and integrates with other ones as well. But it doesn't have as many integrations as Shopify does, as OneClick Upsell does, admittedly. The other big downside that puts a lot of people off immediately is a $300 a month commitment, okay? It's a pretty big commitment. One of the most expensive apps, but it does have no transaction fees. Okay, so if you're doing big, big, big numbers, that $300 fee can actually be less than the OneClick Upsell fee, okay? Because of the 1.5%. So you need to calculate that and see what you're more comfortable with. It can have up to 6 post-purchase upsells. Unfortunately, it can't do split testing of each of those pages. You can increase your average order value 10-15%. Again, 7-12, realistically. The big, 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 big benefit of Cart Hook is the one-page checkout. Okay, so the big benefit over one-click upsell is the one-page checkout. Definitely helps boost your conversion rates. You look at some of these massive stores where they've heavily optimized their funnel, and one-page checkouts work really well, okay? Just extremely well, rather than the Shopify one where they have to go click, 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 okay? This is just, it's all on the one page and they just complete order, okay? That makes a big difference. It's the one main benefit over one-click upsell. Doesn't have SMS bump integration, no messenger integration, and again, just generally a lot of third-party apps want to integrate with it. It has some sync problems as well. Okay, so I'm just going to show you these apps now. Okay, guys, so here's your winning product, and you can also use this store for product research as well, has plenty of winning products. Is the Peekaboo Singing Elephant, okay? So you can actually see here, this is a winning product that's trending on Facebook right now. So you can actually use this. Truthfully speaking, I tried marketing this over a year ago, and it didn't work for me. For some reason, it's now actually trending. But this is definitely a winning product. So you've got the description, you've got the buttons. I would use these pages as reference. We can tell it's trending as well. If we have a look on AliExpress, you can see that that was technically my first win product. Anyway, but this one, we can see here that it's priced at 11 to 15 US. So we've got, and people are charging $38. Okay, and that I believe is in Australian. But you can see you've got a decent margin. So we can get at least sell this for $15 to $20 on top. So you got a good margin, which meets the criteria for Facebook of having about a $15 margin to really be healthy nowadays to at least take home a good amount, okay? So we've got that, all right? So we know that, and we can see it's got a ton of orders. Like, look at this. So, you know, 8,000, 2,000, 1,000, and you've got the dog one as well, which is another potential winning one as well. So we've got plenty of data here that we're seeing that this is definitely doing well. Other people are dropshipping it. And if we have a look on Facebook, we can see here that a heap of people, you know, that's from October, but we can see that just the 11th of January. So if we have a look at 2019, we can see that it's trending upwards. Okay, so we can see that 30,000, 112,000, 120,000, 60, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so you can see this is definitely a trending product. So I always would go off the one that's doing the best, use theirs as reference, and start getting testing, okay, guys? So that's your winning. So here's OneClick Upsell here. It's made from Zipify, and you can see that this is their solution here, that it's their main product. They also do Zipify pages for landing pages, but you can see here you got OneClick Upsell. Sorry, it's actually $47 a month, I tell a lie. It's used by thousands of stores, as you can see, and it helps you to build your landing pages, okay? Just go zipify.com. There's a link down below as well. It's not an affiliate link, just keeping that in mind. There's Carthook, okay? And Carthook, this is carthook.com. There's a link down below that is an affiliate link. You can see here it's used by a lot of large businesses. You can see it's used by Organifi. So if you actually have a look at Organifi.com, they actually use it for one page checkout. That's actually the main reason they use it. It's got a 14-day trial. You can see here that you can, you know, you can actually modify the checkout page. You can modify every funnel step and the thank you page, which does make quite a difference to your LTV in that it is just an expensive app, unfortunately. You can see it's generated a butt ton of money. It is a very good app. It, as I said, the main drawbacks is integrations. As well as I want to inform you that these, the worst part with these is your Facebook pixel firing can sometimes double fire, okay? Because it and so it'll actually sometimes triple fire. So if they keep adding more things to cart, Facebook defines that as a whole new purchase when it's actually just a combined one purchase. So if you see in your pixel that you've got one add to cart but seven purchases, let's say something like that as an example, let's say five purchases, it's actually that one person has purchased and they've taken like five of your upsells, okay? So that's pretty much what that is. That's important to keep in mind, all right? And that's why Reconvert, especially when you're a beginner and on a new store, I definitely recommend using Reconvert because it has no integration problems. It's free, it's a popular app, it's easy to use. You can see here that, you know, it helps stores generate an extra, you know, 5 to 10%, not a huge amount, but that's money in your back pocket you're paying nothing for. It integrates normally, you have no problems. You can see here it's got a pop-up. That pop-up converts really well, and it's got integration, and it's going to be only getting better, okay, guys? So that is my recommendation there, and that's them, all right? So last slide I just wanted to pretty much discuss was to discuss when to use each app, okay? I've sort of said it anyway, but use Reconvert when you're starting out. If you're a newbie, install Reconvert. Completely free, there's no reason to not. Takes 10 minutes to get set up. Use the Monster, I think it's the Monster conversion template that I have, and just slightly jig it, okay? Just spend 10, 15 minutes jigging it. Once you get sales, try OCU. Okay, you do want to try OCU. It is going to get you more revenue. Okay, guys, make sure that you have your integrations airtight. Okay, I have helped heaps of students that use this to get a lot of sales, but they don't look at the integration. So all of a sudden, their abandoned cart emails are not working, and their pixel's not firing properly. Their Google Analytics isn't updated. It's really important that you do that, guys. That's bread and butter of this, because the more data you have, the more information you have, the better decision-making you can make. And I see too many people make that mistake. It's a mistake. I've seen some of the biggest people in the world mistake. Okay, so Cart Hook as well has the same thing. Integration's airtight. Definitely do try Cart Hook as a 14-day trial once you have consistent sales. Okay, so reconvert OCU, Cart Hook, and see which you find does better. My personal preference is Cart Hook, just purely because that one page checkout is just such a high converting thing. The integrations is a problem. If OCU can get, which it is, SMS bump integration as well as one page checkout, it's definitely going to be the king. Okay, but as far as I'm aware, the one page checkout is not something happening yet, which is a real pain for us. We just can't seem realistically between all three of these to win. So definitely start with Reconvert, try OCU. There's no harm staying with OCU. I know a number of people that stay with OCU and love it, and I think it's a fantastic app. But try Carthook and just see the difference in results you get. Just in that 2-week trial, it's not gonna cost you any extra. Turn OCU off and just see if that actually converts better. But either way, once you're scaling, you definitely need post-purchase upsells and proper ones, okay, guys? That will make a big difference to your bottom line so you can outcompete everyone, okay? Hey everyone, so I hope you have enjoyed today's video on how to increase your revenue and get a lot more repeat customers, and my review on which one to use and where to use them, okay guys? Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, hit that notification bell for updates, and I hope you enjoyed that free winning product. Let me know below if you do like the way that these videos are now being made, really trying to incorporate everyone's feedback there. Further to this as well, I do want to add that my mentoring program is still open, as well as I do accept coaching calls, okay? So the coaching calls are 30, 60-minute coaching calls, while the mentoring program is a monthly program, month by month, okay? Now, I do want to add as well that this is a program that does cost money. I'm not doing it entirely for free, okay? I've had a number of people ask that. I just want to clarify that entirely. We have to find if we're a good fit. I can help beginners through to experts, okay, guys? That is perfectly fine to answer your question there. So as long as you're committed and that you're accepted into the program, we can go to that next stage. But I hope you have enjoyed today's video. I'll catch you in the next video. Thank you for your time. And